Now we have our empirical formula. Those subscripts that we found in the previous step are as shown, and now it's on to figure out our molecular formula. So the next step is to figure out the molar mass of this empirical formula. Start with your carbon, which we have 5 of them, and multiply by the individual molar mass of carbon. We'll get 60.05. Do the same for hydrogen, now there are 7, times that 1.01 and you get 7.07. But there's only one nitrogen, so we don't even have to really multiply. It's 1 times 14.01, which is itself. We'll add all these values together and your molar mass of your empirical formula gives you 81.13 grams per mole. Your next step is to divide. You will be dividing your molecular formula's molar mass divided by the empirical formula's molar mass. In the initial question, you were given the molecular formula's molar mass. You will always be given that because there is no other way to figure out the molecular formula without the molecular formula's molar mass. We found our empirical formula's molar mass, and a nice little trick for you to remember that molecular formula's molar mass goes on top and the empirical formula's molar mass goes on the bottom is please, oh please, don't forget about me. Me, molecular formula on top, empirical formula's molar mass on the bottom. So we'll divide those two values in our case, and these grams per mole will cancel, and you get a whole number of 2. Our final step is to multiply that whole number, which was 2 that we found in the previous step, to each subscript of your empirical formula. So in the black, you'll see our empirical formula. We're multiplying by 2 that we found before. And finally, we get our molecular formula of C10, H14, and N2. This is the exact chemical formula of nicotine.